how to equalize guest and host sound in Descript. Well, equalizing is a bit, you know, you're probably looking for an automated solution, which Descript doesn't do, by the way. This normalization thing that they do when you have it on enabled in the settings or in the project level, auto-normalize and everything, they will try to do that. But I found that it's really not that effective because I think, my opinion, is that the normalization happens on the peak values. So if you have a person kind of, you know, being kind of quiet throughout the episode, but at some point they kind of laugh or they clap or they do something very loud, the normalization is going to be relative to that particular loud point. That's the peak, okay? And then everything is going to be done from there lower, okay? And if you already done edits and things like that, and you want to do it inside of Descript, there's a way to do it. If you have multi-track, like I do here, okay? So I'm going to the project and you see that I've got two files. So every person has different files. And then I have a sequence right there, Christy and Chris or whatever. I can edit that sequence. So I can right click on it and go to edit sequence. And you see here now the two tracks, okay? So what you can do if, let's assume that, I'm going to zoom out, all right? So let's assume that Chris is too loud. I'm looking at the waveforms and he looks like, you know, some of his portions are peaking, okay? So I say, you know what? I want to take Chris's track. So you click on that and I'm going to change the level. You see it's plus 11 dB. I think that's what the auto normalization determined that it needs to be lifted to 11 dB to make sure that it's all, you know, loud, normalized, minus whatever. So I can just change that. Look, I can grab that and drag it. And you can see the waveform kind of going lower, right? So it's now like half plus 5. And there you go. You see, it's lower now. And that you can do in here if your tracks are separate. Just click on the track, lower it, raise it, play back, you know, play back to listen to it. You know, make sure it doesn't clip. It doesn't go over the level there. And then when you're happy, you click done. And now these levels are going to be reflecting in your compositions everywhere. Okay. Everywhere you're using that sequence is going to now reflect this change for that track. Okay. So that's one way to do it. But it's a bit of, it's a manual thing because Descript doesn't do this automatically. Now there's another point I want to make. If I right click in here and go back into the sequence for a second, let's assume that maybe you don't want to raise the entire track. Maybe you just want to adjust one portion, which might be low. Let's say the rest is good, but one portion is low, okay? Or high, whatever. So you can isolate that and you can go to the blade tool inside the sequence. So, you know, remember I am inside the sequence now. Use the blade tool and go on the timeline here. And I'm just going to assume that this is the part that I want to maybe change the volume for. You have to isolate that from the rest. Okay. So I'm going to make a cut before that and one cut after that. So you see these cuts have now changed and I've created three segments here. Okay. The portion I want to raise, it's its own clip. And then these two are the rest of the track. Okay. Then you go to the select tool and you select this segment. And now you can change the volume just for that segment. Watch this. Look, you see, I am actually going to mute it. All right. So there you go. That segment has no audio right now. Okay. The video is still there, but the audio is muted. And you can amplify it. You can turn it down, whatever you want to do. There's a lot of clicks involved because the range tool doesn't work the same way like it does in a composition for some reason. Because if you have video and you want to say, hey, you know what? I'm going to just use the range tool and I'm going to make a selection in here and I'm going to delete it. Because I don't care for that audio. But watch this. I have deleted the video as well. Okay. So that's not, I don't want that. So that's why you need to do all this trick about cutting out, isolating that segment just so that you can select it and mute it.